Good morning. The international law, private international law deals with several concepts. Is one of concept was admired. This would work both internationally. In domestic cases also. So you kindly try to understand what is private international law and what is public international law. Public international law deals with dispute between the countries, and the private international law deals with private organization, entity or person. See, the price law, recognition, insurgency, all these things are public international law. The law of admiralty, arbitration, seat of administration, lex pori, everything is deals with private international law. I would like to discuss about a judgment to make you understand the Contract Act as well as the admiralty jurisdiction and the Settlement of Maritime Claims Act, Act 22 of 2017. Section 421F, Section 21G. See, we are wherein, for want of the law of necessity, you know, which way law of necessity deals with the two contractual supply and quasi-contractual supply. Suppose there is a contract between the family head to the provisional supplier, that supply provisions to family and I will repay on every month, or he say that I will pay 1st July. Suppose he did not return back. But because if you did not supply provisions to the family members, there is possibility of loss of life or deterioration of health. Therefore, we may supply the necessities, and particularly supply to the minors would entitle you to claim your amount on the basis of quasi-contract. That you should try to understand. This is the case wherein the question of vessels, the word flag correlated with the vessel. Owner of the vessels are different, and the charter vessels are different. That is SS steamship vessels and the ME motor vehicle vessels. Vessels mean ship and boat, everything has come. A Republic of Cyprus a ship landed and bunkers were supplied there was an agreement, but he did not pay the amount, therefore the suit was filed and this jurisdiction was invoked, Admiralty Jurisdiction, Settlement of Maritime Claims, wherein the ship was arrested and detained, and thereafter some compromise was arrived between them, and despite that compromise the amount was not paid, therefore suit was filed. You want to understand the entirety of law, instead of reading these provisions I would read only 62 and 63 of the Contract Act about novation of contract, a simple subject for law undergraduates and students. The other provisions somewhat excel, that you have to go through it. So many international conventions and jurisprudence of other courts, lot of admiralty law in England were discussed, what is Admiralty Court Act 1840, then Colonial Courts of Admiralty, India Act 1891, were discussed. Those who are interested may go through all those things. Then the question was, there was a definition about maritime lien. There is maritime lien was discussed. What is lien means? After supplying your goods, you can retain the vehicle, vessels, for your claim. That is, therefore, maritime claim was defined, maritime lien was also defined. That you have to go through it. My mere reading would not help you. Then, they are after discussing all this, Brussels Convention, Elizabeth Judgment, the question was novation of contract. For that, to simplify to understand this, 62, effect of novation, rescission and alteration of contract. If already a contract was executed and subsequently on the basis of the same transaction you want to enter into another contract, then 62 of contract acts, if the parties to a contract agreed to substitute a new contract for it or to rescind or alter it, the original contract need not be performed. That was the then 63. Promise may dispense with or remit performance of promise. Every promise may dispense with or remit wholly or in part the performance of promise made to, or may extend time for such performance, or may accept instead of it by satisfaction which he thinks fit. These cases would help you. So, if the modified contract has no independent contractual force, in that it has no meaning and content separately from and independently of the original contract. These all are the words they have used. They have also discussed about Section 63 of the Contract Act, wherein some explanations, illustrations were given to understand the Contract Act. And finally, the High Court order, which was set aside by the Division Bench, was set aside by the Supreme Court, holding that this 63 contract based upon the Contract Act, the single judge judgment was hold good. See AR 2017, Supreme Court 5530, Chrysomer Corporation vs. MGR Steel Private Limited. This is the case they have finally discussed. Then they are, you see, about maritime lien, several provisions were, US laws were discussed. So that is there. Then those who are interested in this field of maritime, the lawyers at Tuticorin, Madras, dealing with ship transactions, must concentrate on the judgment and equip yourselves. Then the International Convention, Arrest of Ship, 1999, they say excess right of arrest. Arrest means detaining the vehicle. Finally, the expression altered in Section 62 of the Contract Act was correct law, they say. Alteration must go to the very root of the original contract, change is its essential content, so that modified contract must be read as doing with the original contract. So if the modified has no independent contractual force, then they said the single judge judgment is good. They say there would be a degree against vessel M.E. Nicholas equivalent to 42,57,000 in Indian currency. The plaintiff would be entitled to recover the same security punished to restore High Court. Original side together with accrued interest thereon. So the appeal is accordingly allowed. So they restore the single judge judgment. So I may be, because for want of short of time, so my endeavor to bring this judgment is for the Excel students to kindly go through this judgment, read once, twice, thrice, and equip you with this admiralty law. And for beginners, this novation of contract, how to apply novation of contract and Indian contract, and also what is lien. You could understand maritime lien, maritime claim. Simple two terms. That's an best.